Galactus has finally arrived, and the invasion of the Fortnite Island has begun. It's all about the Zero Point, the incredibly powerful energy source that caused our old island to literally get sucked in a black hole. And if Galactus consumes it during the event, this could be the end of the Fortnite Island as we know it. We're talking absolute annihilation of both space and time. But we've been preparing for this. With the new upgraded battle bus Tony Stark has built to wage war to finally every Marvel superhero besides one being on the island, this is everything you need to know about the Fortnite Nexus War event. And make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out on all the videos we're about to drop over the next few weeks. This ride is about to get bumpy, so strap in as we cover what we know so far. So there's actually a surprising amount of information out there about the live event, and it gives us a pretty good idea of what could happen. First things first, the live event is estimated to take place between November 28th and November 30th, but we're guessing it'll be the 28th. Either way, that's less than 10 days away, meaning the countdown will begin any day now. As for the name of the event, we have leaks that tell us the playlist will be called The Devourer of Worlds, and the description will be Defend the Island to Save All Reality. And if you're wondering just what this Devourer of Worlds will look like, here's a photo of just how big Galactus is gonna be compared to the rest of the island. Yeah, that's just his head. And of course, because of the sheer size of this guy, it's gonna be pretty hard for the Marvel superheroes to defeat him. Which is why Tony Stark is actually building an upgraded battle bus as we speak, and he's been adding to it every single update. This is the most recent stage, the third stage, and it's received wings. In fact, one of the later stages of the battle bus won't even have a balloon because it'll actually be powered by whatever this weird metal thing is. Although the wings aren't the only thing that we'll see on these buses. There's some leak weapons that are related to the event, and I have a suspicion that one of them is probably gonna be used against Galactus. The first of these leaked weapons is a lasing device, and it sounds pretty vague, but we know it'll be some kind of laser rifle. There's also a leaked weapon called a heavy mortar, and it's pretty much a minigun grenade launcher, which sounds pretty freaking overpowered. How these weapons will be used in the fight against Galactus, we have yet to see if they even will be used. Epic is known for scrapping a lot of stuff, but it's important we mention. The leaks don't stop there because we know that the helicarrier isn't going to be the starter island for much longer, as it'll become a fully functioning POI very soon, even with its own shield henchmen on board. We've been waiting for this thing to arrive for weeks now, and the wait continues. Something we don't have to wait for, though, is this next leak, which actually reveals the sounds we're going to be hearing before the event starts. There's a few things we'll hear as that countdown ticks closer to the event, but one of them is this alarm. There's also some pretty cool orchestral music to hype us up, and with this countdown starting any day now, we could be hearing it sooner than we think. And speaking of the countdown, we are fully expecting Galactus to appear in the Battle Pass lobby in the next few days. This is what it's gonna look like. Anyone else terrified of how big he'll be? And while all of this is very exciting, there's one leak out there which is probably the most important one of all. The files for the black hole from Season X have been re-added into the game, and while it might not mean much, it's very possible we'll be getting some kind of repeat of the Chapter 2 black hole after this event. And so I know what you're all thinking, all of this doesn't really tell us what's actually gonna happen during the event. Like, will the heroes or Galactus win? What will the theme of Season 5 be? What will the Fortnite map look like in a month? Those are great questions, but if you want the answers, we have to go back to where the story all began so it makes sense. It's time we finally conclude the beginning of the Nexus War. Okay, please pay attention here. This is where everything comes full loop and you'll finally see the big picture. During the end of Chapter 1, the Seven contained a massive ball of energy known as the Zero Point, stopping it from exploding and destroying space and time. However, the Zero Point reacted by tearing apart the Chapter 1 island and reorganizing everything onto it into a brand new island that we know and love today. But the amount of energy this took was noticed by a massive ancient being known as Galactus, who roams the universe in search of planets to eat, because, I mean, look at this dude. He's a hungry boy, apparently he needs to eat planets to survive or something. So, while Galactus was working with Thor to stop a deadly threat known as the Black Winter, he was distracted by the energy from the Zero Point. Ignoring Thor's pleas to stop, Galactus flew into the Fortnite Rift and he's been traveling to the island for the last four seasons. Knowing he was approaching, Captain America was bifrosted onto the island first to look around and gain intel on this new mysterious place. Soon after, Thor arrives to the island, and for some mysterious reason, it began to make him forget everything. He resists the power of the island doing this to him, but while he's trying to piece everything together, he's attacked by the inhabitants of the island. After calling for help, all the other Marvel heroes were bifrosted onto the island with Season 4. Welcome to the party, this rabbit hole goes so much deeper. Fast forward a little bit, and we have Tony Stark, who's figured out how to use the Rift energy to teleport other Marvel heroes onto the island. He's even worked out how to rift in his Stark Industries lab, where he knows he has to craft a plan that will stop Galactus or else. I mean, take a look, on his whiteboards you can see that Tony Stark is working on a way to defeat Galactus and save the island for good. He's been experimenting with time travel, rift energy, and most importantly, the Battle Bus. Over time, Stark has been adding little upgrades to the Battle Bus, and while we didn't know for a while what it was for, we now know his plan is to use it in the battle against Galactus. Throughout the course of the season, we deal with numerous obstacles while we prepare for the Great Nexus War, with Galactus' drones attacking the island and an undead shadow problem that nearly ruined everything. But now we move to today, where the event is right around the corner and Galactus is closer than ever. The island has prepared for his arrival, with almost every hero teased at the start of the season now in-game, ready for war. Soon, the countdown to the Nexus War will begin, and we'll be just days away from fighting Galactus in a massive battle to save reality itself. And now that you're caught up, here's what you've all been waiting for, our main theory about the live event. So when the countdown strikes zero, we're gonna see Galactus get closer and closer to the island in his full glory. We're expecting him to not only be the most powerful villain in any live event, but also the biggest, even bigger than Travis Scott, by a mile. To start off, we're gonna guess that the Avengers will all prepare at the helicarrier to fight against Galactus. We know that the helicarrier will be above the Authority because of previous leaks, and well, I mean, Thor also kinda says it in the trailer. It's practically confirming that we will prepare to fight Galactus from the helicarrier. It also brings us to a theory we've had for months. We believe that during this big battle, the superheroes will fight Galactus, but not be strong enough to fully defeat him. They're gonna try all of their abilities on him, but nothing's gonna work. Then Galactus will attack the helicarrier and possibly even destroy it so it crash lands on either the island or in the ocean. If this happened, we might even get it as a destroy POI in season 5. But after he destroys the helicarrier and it looks like he's about to grab the zero point and defeat the heroes, we're probably gonna see Tony Stark appear with his upgraded battle bus to fight Galactus. If you don't remember, usually with events, Epic likes to pretend that the event is over before a big twist, and we think that Tony Stark coming to save the day will be that twist for this event. Let's just hope you'll be able to pull off flying to Galactus without being destroyed first. It's also possible that we could see Captain Marvel midway through the event to save the island, which could also be the twist. So we've got Tony Stark's bus, a destroyed helicarrier, and possibly some new faces like Captain Marvel. That leads me to my next point. It's important to understand what Galactus is after, the zero point, which leaves us the glaring question, where exactly is the zero point? Wild shot in the dark, I'd say it's beneath the Authority or the Redacted Bunker, making these two POIs to be prime targets to be destroyed during the event. And I know what you're all thinking, will Galactus win or lose the battle? Well, turns out there's some evidence that might suggest Galactus could win. A lot of leakers have recently found files in the update that hint at a second black hole happening, and it will apparently have the text to be continued in season 5. This means it's possible we'll get a cliffhanger of Galactus winning the event, and then we'll get a to be continued screen before season 5 begins. I mean, it makes sense, or it's possible that we'll defeat Galactus and get this season 5 teaser anyway. So that's our best theory for what could happen in the Nexus War event, and it will lead directly into season 5. While we're on the topic of season 5, there's still a few leaks out there which might give us a hint at what that theme could be. Let's finish off with everything we know about season 5 and, well, everything else you probably care about. So there are still a ton of Marvel heroes and mythic abilities in the files that haven't been added to the game yet. We've been getting hints and glimpses of a Captain Marvel skin for weeks, with the latest update adding a potential item shop skin for her. We've also got an upcoming ability for Mystique, which is the dual machine pistols. This is already in the files and ready to go, so it could be thrown into the loot pool literally any day now. There's also Nick Fury's eye patch over at the helicarrier, which makes us think that he'll be a boss there once it becomes a POI. I will say this though, it's becoming more likely that Epic has canceled the Nick Fury skin. Not to mention, Black Panther hasn't even released yet, despite him having his own POI and mythic ability. It is possible that Epic might be holding off or have canceled his release completely, it's hard to know. And speaking of new skins, don't forget about the Last Laugh bundle out right now for console owners to buy, which includes Joker, Poison Ivy, and the Midas Rex skin. Midas does still exist as a flopper and appeared in this year's Fortnite Mares, so will his story continue into the next season? We definitely think so. As for Joker and Poison Ivy, there was a pretty popular theory that even we covered that suggested Season 5 could be a Marvel vs. DC crossover. And while it'd be cool and would make a lot of sense, we don't think that's gonna be the theme. Our prediction for the Season 5 theme is that we'll probably see a nostalgic season bringing back old POIs and items from Season 1, like Tilted Towers maybe. Or the more obvious idea that Epic would probably just do a winter theme for Season 5. If they do, it wouldn't be a surprise, but I gotta admit, I wouldn't be as excited. And that is literally everything you need to know about the Galactus Live event. Things are absolutely out of control right now, and while our entire universe is probably gonna get obliterated in the next few weeks, it was my pleasure to cover everything from the beginning. Thanks for tuning in, this has been Tommy, and you're watching Top 5 Gaming.